He's a tzaddik etamim. But when you take a look at the parasha and we read the Rashi, we get a little bit confused. What is he? Is he a real tzaddik or is not so much of a tzaddik? Rashi starts off, Ele toldot noach noach ish tzaddik, oil v'izkiro siper v'shivcho. If the pasuk comes to praise him, zecher tzaddik livracha. So therefore, the Torah says, tzaddik, tamim, beautiful praises. But, next Rashi, בדורותיו, יש מרבותינו דורשים אותו לשבח, ויש שדורשים אותו לגנאי. Some say that it's, the pasuk comes to praise Noach, and some say that the pasuk actually comes to do the opposite. So therefore, we're getting a little bit confused. We're continuing, same idea. את האלוהים יתהלך נוח, Rashi says that Noach was not such a great man like Avraham Avinu. Avraham Avinu was much greater, ואברהם הוא אומר, יתהלך לפניי, אשר התהלכתי לפניו. Noach היה צריך סעד לתומכו. אברהם היה מתחזק ומהלך בצדקו מאליו. So therefore by Avraham he says, יתהלך לפניי. Unlike Noach, over here it says, את האלוהים יתהלך נוח, נוח needed the support of הקדוש ברוך הוא, because he wasn't able to do it on his own. Later on again, we see sometimes the Torah praises Noach very much, sometimes not so much, מקטני המנה, the Torah says, that therefore Noach was hesitant to go into the Teva right away. He was waiting to see the rain coming down until he decided it's time to go in, and Rashi over there criticizes him for being Miktanei Amana, not such a Baal Emuna, and so on and so forth. So when we're trying to read the Pasuk and learn it correctly, we'll go to Pasuk Yudaled, where Rashi tells us that HaKadosh Baruch Hu commended Noach actually to build the Teva way before the rain started. The Mabul started actually, Rashi says, 120 years after this command of HaKadosh Baruch Hu, after the mitzvah that Hashem tells Noach, go and build the Teva. And Rashi wants to know, why is it that Noach had to build the Teva for 120 years? For 120 years, that doesn't take that long to build the Teva. How long does it take to build the Teva? Not 120 years. So Rashi says that Arbe Revach Ve'atzala Lefanav. HaKadosh Baruch Hu could have saved Noach in so many different various ways. There's not a problem for Hashem Yitbarach to save Noach. So why was he Matriach Be'binyan Zeh? Why did he bother him to go and build the Teva? Rashi says, Kedirhu Ador HaMabul Osek Ba Kuf Kaf Shana. He wanted that people should be able to see Noach building at 120 years. So what would they do when they see Noach building at 120 years? They would go and ask him, what are you doing? Shoalim oto, ma zot lecha? And now he gets the opportunity. Once they start talking to him, start getting interested, he has the opportunity to open up and ask them and tell them of what he has to do. אומר להם, עתיד הקדוש ברוך הוא להביא מבול לעולם. You should know that there's going to be a mabul that's going to completely devastate and destroy the world. אולי ישובו, maybe they will make teshuva. So they had that opportunity to do teshuva for that long, 120 years. Again, day in and day out, year goes by and another year goes by and people don't do teshuva. But this was meant in order for people to do teshuva. When you take a look at Sifte Chachamim, Sifte Chachamim asks on this, why? Halo arbe revach ve'atzala lefanav. People are not going to think that the reason for this is actually, as Noach says, that HaKadosh Baruch Hu is bringing them a bull, because they come and claims, says the Sifte Chachamim, that if Hashem wants to save you, he doesn't have to ask you to do a teva. That's very strange. You have to build a teva in order to be saved. Hashem Yitbarach has so many other ways how to save a person without building a teva. As Rashi says over here, Lama etricho bebinyan zeh, why would he bother you if Hashem is taking care of you? If Hashem cares for you, Hashem wants you to be saved, so why does he make it ask you to make such a teva for 120 years? Doesn't make any sense. If I like somebody, I'll save him without. Hashem who can do that? He doesn't have a problem with that. So therefore, the reaction of people should have been the opposite, says the Sifte Chachamim. People should have said, Are you kidding us? Are you joking? What do you mean you're building a teva? If Hashem commanded you, and the sense of it here, he could save you in other ways. That's how the Siftei Chachamim asks. But even more than that, just any person would understand that even if they would believe Noach on the first year, on the second year, but eventually it wears out. How many years you can see a person building a teva and the rain still doesn't start coming? They think that something's wrong with him. You have to go to the institution. What are you talking about? 120 years. If Hashem wants to bring a mabul and such a terrible gezerah, so he told you to build a teva, that's one day, second day, third day, fourth day, fifth day. Why is it that it has to wait 120 years until finally Hashem would bring down the mabul? People are going to see that every year passes by, mabul doesn't come, to completely lose faith in Noach's explanation of why he's building a teva. So in order to understand this correctly, we really have to go to the beginning of the parasha, where the Torah tells us, Ele toldot Noach, Noach ish tzadik, tamim haya bedorotav. You see that the Pasuk says that the praise of Noach, that he was a tzadik tamim, was because et Elohim italech Noach. Now, et Elohim italech Noach is not a simple praise over here, because the Torah says that that praise gives him the title Ish Tzadik Tamim. He's righteous, he's complete. Tzadik Tamim. That's not a simple praise. This is an unbelievable great praise that Noach receives over here. Actually, Rashi later on says and tells us that when Hashem is talking to Noach, he says, Otcha ra'iti tzadik lefanai bador hazeh. Hashem, when he speaks to Noach, he doesn't use the terms tzadik tamim, just tzadik, only righteous. Why does he take out the praise tamim from the title of Noach? Says Rashi velo ne'emar tzadik. Because when you speak to a person, you say part of his praise, but not in front of him, you can say all the praise, tzadik tamim. So over here, Noach, real praise was Ish Tzadik Tamim, an unbelievable great praise. And what was the purpose of the praise? It's because et Elohim italech Noach. He walked together with HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Now one might think, unbelievable thing, et Elohim italech Noach, Hashem is walking together with Noach. He's walking together with Elohim. But Rashi tells us over here that he's not explaining the great praise. I'm a Vinu. It's the greatest of all. It says that Hashem says, Hitalech lefanai, which means Avraham Avinu could have walked by himself. He didn't need to walk together with Hashem Yitbarach. But Noach needed to walk together with him. He needed help. He needed support, Rashi says. Noach wouldn't be able to do it otherwise. Noach haya tzarich sa'ad letamcho. Aval Avraham haya mitchazek umealech betzidko lefmeh. Siftei Chachamim opens up the door over here to understand what does it mean Noach needed support, Avraham didn't need support, what does it mean? So Siftei Chachamim tells us here that Avraham Avinu was very different than Noach. Noach, since he wasn't very, very strong in his emunah, as we saw later on, miktane emunah, he was also very easily influenced by the society, unlike Avraham Avinu. So therefore, Noach was not able to go and mingle around the people and be able to influence them with the words of Hashem. If Noach understood that Hashem is controlling the world, Hashem created the world, Hashem is the Elohim, he's the one that takes care of everything, he should have been able to go out and send the message to the people. But Noach was not able to do that. Why not? Because he would be easily influenced by the society. As the Rambam says, that there's nothing more influential on a person than the society. You are what the society is. When you live amongst people, slowly, slowly, you become like them. So Noach was afraid that he would be influenced from the people. He stayed away. He stayed in his own home. Avraham Avinu, on the other hand, was a solid man. Avraham Avinu was somebody that nobody could influence. Avraham Avinu was able to jump into the fire in Ukasdim, and nothing would budge him, nothing would move him. He was a self-made man that nobody could have influence him in any way. And therefore, HaKadosh Baruch Hu didn't need to support him in any way. And therefore, that means, says the Sifter Chachamim, Avraham Avinu was able to go out to the people, speak to them, argue with them, bring them close to Hashem by approaching them. So these are the two people that we are meeting right away in the beginning of the parasha. Avraham Avinu in last week's parasha was, in next week's parasha, will be such a person that will go to the people and be able to influence the people by reaching out to them. Unlike Noah, Noah is not able to reach to the people because he was afraid he would be influenced. So if that's the case, why does he get the title of Tzadik Tamim? And the Torah says the reason he's a Tzadik Tamim is because Et Elohim Italech Noach. He gets the title of Tzadik Tamim because he Elohim Italech Noach. He didn't go and reach out to the people. And the answer is obviously because Noach knew his abilities, and he knew that since he's not able to be as strong as Avraham Avinu will be in the next generations, 10 generations away from now, so therefore, Noach understood his strength and knew that for him it's the right things to stay home, not to mingle with the people. So for that, Noach gets a praise, Tzadik Tamim. He's not as big as Avraham Avinu, but Et Elokim Italech Noach, he did the right thing. He stayed away from the people, and that's the greatest praise of all when a person can come up to understand what he's able to do and what he's not able to do. And therefore, because of that, we see that a Kadosh Baruch Hu that saw that Noach is watching himself very careful. He's not going to fall to the society. He doesn't want to mingle with the people, although there's a great opportunity for Noach. If he would reach out to the people, it would be Mezakeh Arabim. He's a man within a complete world of people that don't know Hashem. So you go out there and you speak to the people and you convince them how many people you can influence by putting truth in their head, explain to them, putting sense in their head. But Noach doesn't do any of that. So one would think that's a terrible thing. That's the Torah really comes and criticizes Noach for saying, May Noach, the May Mabula called May Noach because Noach didn't go out to reach out to the people. But on the other hand, although Noach had that fault, he wasn't able to reach out to the people, but the Torah still calls him on the same time Tzadik Tamim. Why is that? Because Noach knew that if I'm not reaching out to the people because I'm afraid to be influenced by them and I'm staying home, that's still a good thing. It's still something that each person should see and evaluate. Is it something, do I have the powers, do I have the means to go out and influence other people? And if I don't think so, I'm not allowed to go out there. If I do, I'm like Avraham Avinu, I think I'm solid, I can go speak to people, and they're not going to move me one inch from my belief in HaKadosh Baruch Hu, from doing the mitzvot, from becoming like their corrupted ways, then I should go and follow Avraham Avinu's ways, going to the people, reaching out and talking to them and arguing it out. But if I know that I'm not that strong, I can fall down, I could be weakened in any way, whether it is in emunah, whether it is in following people's ways. People do terrible, terrible things, and if I reach out to them, I can be influenced from them. Therefore, I know that it's not worthwhile, although the ways going out would be unbelievable thing, but on the other hand, if it's the account of falling down, getting a emunah weakened, doesn't for Noach in one hand being criticized that he's not the best, may Noach bedorotav, maya bedoroshel Avraham, and so on and so forth, doshim oto legnai. But on the same, HaKadosh Baruch Hu himself comes to Noach, he says, Otcha ra'iti. So when HaKadosh Baruch Hu is talking to him, he's praising him, and the Torah starts Tzadik Tamim. So it works out because since Noach understood his level and he followed home, reach out and fall down, he gets the prize for that. So therefore, could be very much that that is the reason that Hashem Yitbarach tells him go and make the teva. Why is that? Because HaKadosh Baruch Hu wanted that in one hand, Noach should be able to show people that they're not doing the right thing, but on the same time, not mingle with the people. So how do you do that? HaKadosh Baruch Hu says, if you go and build a teva, 120 years you go and build a teva, you'll be busy all that time with the teva, you're not going to be able to pay attention to the people, and therefore you're not going to be influenced from them. But on the same time as you're building the teva, people are going to come and ask you, what is this, what is this? And you tell them, oh, there's a mabul coming, there's a mabul coming. So that's a strange thing, what he's doing. But since Hashem Yitbarach saw that it's the right thing that Noach should be away from the people, he's not going to be involved with the people, so therefore Hashem Yitbarach gave him such a task. Lama et richo bebinyan zera, she says, kedei shiru anshe dor ha-mabul osek bam kuf kaf shana. 120 years Noach is busy with that. Why? To stay away from the people, but on the same time send out the message. Today we also have an ability to do such a wonderful thing. It used to be that in order to reach out to people, you had to go down there. You had to go to their filth. You had to go to their ways. If they're going to terrible places, in order to reach out, you have to go and speak to them over there. And therefore, every man should have been evaluating his strength. Is it possible to do it for me or not? Can I do it, or might follow their ways? I might be weakened. But today, we have all kind of ways that a person could influence others without being influenced. He could reach out to others, but keep himself protected. How would a person do that? Today with the media, there's a beautiful way a person can do it with reaching out, shiurim, without being actually involved with the people. A person could speak out on the radio, on different ways in the media, that the people could listen to him, but on the same time, those people that might hurt him would stay away from his reach. So therefore, there is a certain connection that a person could do to them. Every one of us should be able to pick out one of those ways and go on that goal and try to reach out as much as possible, because today we have the same opportunity as Noah had. You are busy doing your things, but on the same time, you're busy giving out the message. You're busy giving out the message without putting yourself online that you could be hurt in any way. This is what Rashi tells us. Kedei shiru anshe dor ha-mabul osek ba-kuf kaf shana ve-shoalim oto ma zot lecha. What are you doing? But Noach, while he's building the teva, he doesn't have the time to be influenced from them. So all he's doing is answering their questions. Where's the argument over here? Where's the give and take? Where's the reaching out? There's no reaching out. It's a question and an answer. Once you get the answer, you go, keep going. People went out, and Noach stayed at Tzadik Tamim Haya Bedorotav. Because that reason, Noach was saved. Interesting thing that Rashi tells us in the first Rashi. What does it mean, Ele Toldot Noach? What does that mean, Ele Toldot Noach? Rashi tells us over here, Lelamedcha Shikar Toldotehem Shel Tzadikim Maasim Tovim. Toldot Noach means those are the children of Noach. And the Torah doesn't speak right away about the children. Rather, the next pasuk, Vayoled Noach. But the first pasuk just says, Ele toldot Noach, Noach ish tzadik tamim. So Rashi says, where's the pasuk saying the children of Noach in the first pasuk? And Rashi answers, that is the children. Ele toldot Noach, those are the children of Noach. What are they? Tzadik, tamim, the mitzvot that a person does, those are the toldot of Noach. So Rashi says again, Yesh b'rabotenu lelamedcha shikar toldotehem shel tzadikim maasim tovim. But according to what we're saying right now, it's something very strange. Maasim tovim? Noach didn't do any maasim tovim. He didn't reach out to the people. What maasim tovim? Did he have mitzvot to do? He had taryag mitzvot. What maasim tovim? Maasim tovim, that should be reach out to people, do chesed, help people. But thing over here, at the I didn't do yet. He stayed home. So therefore, Masim Tovim, the Rashi tells us, those are the children of Noach, the Masim Tovim that he's doing. Where's the Masim Tovim? So over here we need to know a Mishnah, Makot Kafel Amud Bet. The Mishnah says the following, Kasher Yaseh Otam Adam V'Chai Bahem, says the Pasuk. Those are the things that a person will do and he would live with them. He would be rewarded. He will get a sachar. Says the Mishnah, Hakol HaYoshev V'Lo Avar Avera Notnim Lo Sachar Keoseh Mitzvah. When a person has an opportunity to do a Avera, to be influenced by the bad people, to follow them, to do a sin, and he stays back, he holds back, he doesn't do that Avera, says the Pasuk and Mishnah, Hakol HaYoshev V'Lo Avar Avera Notnim Lo Sachar Keoseh Mitzvah, is considered like a person that's doing a mitzvah. When you have a certain sin come your way, Yetzara comes to attack, tells you, go ahead, go for it, do it, don't lose out, and you hold back, the Mishnah says, Hakol HaYoshev V'Lo Avar Avera Notnim Lo Sachar Keoseh Mitzvah. And therefore the Pasuk comes and says about Noach, Ele Toldot Noach, those are the praises of Noach, those are the Masim Tovim that Noach made, those are the mitzvot of Noach made. Noach is tzadik tamim, says Rashi, Lelamedcha shikar toldotem shel tzadikim masim tovim. Which masim tovim? The fact that he held back. Mishnah says that once you hold back, it's considered as doing a mitzvah. Rashi explains over there, where do you learn it from? Because it says in the Pasuk that we, as we explained, Asher yaseh otam adam v'chai v'hem, you get over here a sachar for doing something, and the Pasuk itself says, what are you supposed to do? Ishi shel kol sher besaro. Stay away from doing averot. Stay away from doing averot. You get rewarded. You get rewarded for not doing averot. The answer is yes. The Mishnah says in Makot Kaf Gimel, that is the way you learn that just by not doing avera, you get rewarded as doing a mitzvah. Rav Shimon Bar Levi says over there, that arei hu omer rak chazak levilti echol et adam ki adam hu nefesh. The Torah comes and warns us. Make sure, hold back, hold strong, straighten yourself. Don't eat any blood. Don't drink blood. Strange, very strange. Who wants to eat blood? Blood is disgusting. Who would eat black? Nafsho shel adam katza b'hem. That's something that you have to hold back very strongly. What does the Mishnah comes to say? What is the Torah comes to say? So Rav Shimon Bar Levi says in the same Mishnah that the fact that it says rak chazak levilti achol et adam comes to teach me the following. Umayim adam shenafsho shel adam katza mimenu aporesh mimenu mekabel sachar. If blood that a fur person feels disgusted from and he doesn't want to put it in his mouth whatsoever, it's something that you can't tolerate. Still, the Torah says, strengthen yourself, make sure you don't fall to it, make sure that you hold back very strongly. So, gezel v'arayot shenafsho shel adam mitava lahem u'mechametan, aporesh mehem al achat kama v'chama. The Torah comes and says that even more so, how much more so, for those things that a person does have the tava, gezel v'arayot, that a person on that holds back, how much more Hashem would reward him for that? So over here, that's what we're talking about, this corrupted generation of Noach. Vatishachet ha'aretz lifnei Elohim. Vatimale ha'aretz chamas. Everything was done over there. The way Rashi explains, Hashon erva, v'avodah zarah, there was arayot over there, there was avodah zarah, timale ha'aretz chamas, there was gezel, and if on dam, the Torah says, hold back, you're going to get rewarded just for holding back from something you disgusted. So therefore, how much more so would be on Gezel and Arayot? And over here, Noah held back. The whole streets were filled with Gezel, Avodah Zarah, Arayot. Vatishachet ha'aretz lifnei Elohim, vatimalei ha'aretz chamas. It was everywhere. You went out of the house, you saw people doing Averot. So therefore, when Noah held back from all that, the Mishnah says it's considered as he was doing mitzvot every second. And therefore the Torah says on that, Ele toldot Noach, Noach ish tzadik lelamedcha, sheikar toldotem shel tzadikim, maasim tovim, unbelievable. Unbelievable. And the Igrot Moshe, Rav Moshe Feinstein tells us in Yored De'akuf Nun Vav, a concept that we don't find in other places, but that's what he teaches us, that the person should make sure not to go around people that do Avera. A question, if you see somebody's doing Avera, are you allowed to be around him and see him doing the Avera? Or maybe you should hold away, stay away, run away. One might say, I'm not doing the Avera, he's doing the Avera. Maybe it's not nice to see it, maybe it's not polite, maybe it's disrespectful to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. But where does it say anywhere in the Torah or in the Halakha that one is not allowed to see? For instance, I'll give you an example. In Israel, they have soccer games on Shabbat. That over there, the Chilulei Shabbat are unbelievable. People go there. They do every Chilul Shabbat possible. They drive there. They smoke. There's electricity in the place, on and off, whatever it is. And therefore, they came in a certain solution for those that keep Shabbat that would be able to go to a place without being Mechalel Shabbat. If somebody could come himself by his own without driving a car, he doesn't have to hand the ticket away because they made a system that would where you are. Therefore, you walk in, you don't have Shabbat. You can sit in the stadium and watch the soccer game. Beautiful. You sit there for a couple of hours. In the end of the game, you could go home. You didn't violate. So, one might say, no problem at all, no problem. But what Moshe tells us, you need to know, the question that he came in front of him was, someone that was a mohel, and he had a brit milah, but he knew that that brit milah would be filled with people that violate the Shabbat. There would be over there everything of chilulei Shabbat. People would be smoking, people would be driving, people would do averot in there. So he asked of Moshe Feinstein, should I go to such a place or maybe I shouldn't go? Could I go to a place? Shabbat? So Moshe writes the following, בדבר שמזדמן לברית מילה אצל מעלת כבודו, ילך שלא יראה במחללי שבת. You ask that people violate the Shabbat right in front of you. You already rebuke them. You already told them not to do it and they're not listening. He says, this definitely, he says, vadai, definitely a violation, definitely forbidden to go to a place that he sees people violating the Torah. If you see somebody violating the Torah, you're not allowed to be there, says Rav Moshe. Af shevadai yesh isur al ha'adam lelech lemakom shovrim isure Torah. V'reaya, what's the proof? Where does Rav Moshe bring this from? The Gemara in Yuma says, Yuma daf ein, that there is a mitzvah to see people that do mitzvot. To see the Kohen Gadol, to see the Avodah in Bet HaMikdash. Yesh mitzvah lir'ot be'asiyat mitzvah mishum berov am adrat melech. There's a mitzvah to go out there and to see those that do mitzvot and to do it publicly, that's even better. So says Rav Moshe, you learn over here, very simple, kal v'chomer, im ken. Shaminan mimele delirot be'avera yesh isur da berov am huchas v'shalom bizayon lamelech. If going to see in the praise of the king is considered a mitzvah, says the Gemara in Yuma daf ayin, therefore must be that going to a place and seeing people violating the Torah, that's definitely chilul Hashem berov am. Same thing as a mitzvah could be a greater mitzvah if it's done publicly, so does the bizayon to the melech, the degrading event that's going on over here of spitting in front of HaKadosh Baruch Hu and putting him down in such a way that they're violating the Torah and his command and his word, and it's done in a public way, a person must not go to such a place. So Moshe says, but since there's a mitzvah of Brit Milah, he should go there, do the Milah, and as soon as the Milah is done, right away escape, go out of there. And Moshe that says that, I found same idea in the Mechilta itself. The Mechilta brings the Tosefta. The Tosefta brings that a person that sees someone's doing a mitzvah, it's a zchut for him. A person that sees somebody that's doing avera, it's a chov for him. It's something bad. It's a sin for him. That's how the Tosefta brings down. So that same idea that Moshe teaches us, same idea we found that Moshe says that you're not allowed to pray in a place that they're doing averot in that place. If avera was done in a place, that doesn't make the place not fit for praying. But if a place was built in order to do averot in such a place, he speaks about a Moshe over there, that you have, for instance, a hall that was made for mixed dancing, things like that. That was the hall about. And now, let's say, for Rosh Hashanah, you're looking for a hall for your minyan, and you need something, your shul doesn't hold the people, and you find such a place. So can you go to such a place? Says a Moshe, no. The kedusha of the place has a lot of influence of on the tefillah. He brings this from the Gemara in Brachot, that Hashem loves those places that are places of learning, places of praying, those places where a person should pray. But the opposite, a place that was made for holelut, for things, for averot, one is not allowed to pray in such a place. That's how Moshe says. So we learn from here that it's not only important to be surrounded with such people that are good, and to stay away from people that are bad. You're not even allowed to see them. And Moshe says that even you're not allowed to pray in a place that even though right now they're not there, but since the place is made for that, one is not allowed to pray in such a place. And we found that the influence of a tzaddik also and the rasha has an influence of one, on one's tefillah as well, because the Sefer Hasidim says that when you pray within the Dalet Amot of a tzaddik, so your tefillah is reaching out higher. And if you pray in a Dalet Amot of a Rasha, so the tefillah is a problem. It could be that we look at it in two ways. In one way, we're saying that, yes, the tefillah of the tzaddik goes up, and your tefillah goes up with it together. It goes up together. That's much more powerful. The tefillah of a Rasha, Kadosh Baruch Hu says, Lama lirov zivchachem, he's not interested in his tefillah. So therefore, the tefillah that the Rasha is being blocked, together with that, blocked everything surrounding him as well. But could be there's also a question of influence over here. When you're surrounded with the tzaddik, you're close to him. So you see how he prays in such kavanah. That has an effect on you. You see how he's very, very much involved in his tefillah. So you try to pay attention to your tefillah. But on the Rasha, you see that he comes in, and within a minute, sometimes less than a minute, you see a person walks into shul. He takes the sidur. Before you finish the bracha that you started, he's already the end of the tefillah finish. He's already taking the three steps back, and he's coming out of the shul. How did he do that so fast? How could you say it so fast? But when you are around such people, you start doing the same thing. You see that a person goes to shul, and in the shul, people are taking out their cell phones, and they're starting to look within their cell phone in the tefillah. So that wears out the feeling of tefillah within us as well. So we feel, no, nishkafelach, I'll take out my cell phone as well when I need to. But if people are very careful, if they have to use the cell phone very, very much, so they'll go out of the shul. Shul is respected. You're not allowed to open the cell phone in the shul. So if that's the case, you'll feel the same way. You are what the surrounding around you teach you. And this is what it says in the Avot. In the beginning of Avot, Avot Aleph, Zayin. Natai ha'arbali omer, archek mishachen ra, ve'al titchaver la'rasha. Make sure to stay away from a bad neighbor and don't attach yourself to wicked people. Why is it that you have to stay away? What is it that this neighbor that's around you is so bad that you always might make sure when you open the door, see if he's coming out, stay home until he leaves the place. Once you see that he's not in the block, then you can come out. You always have to make sure. Harchek mishachen ra. You see, you're coming home, and you see him also coming to the door. So you stay away. You go around the block, and you come back when he's already home. Why is that? Says the Partanura Shelo Tilmod Mimasav. You see him doing things that are wrong, you're learning from him. You talking to him, he's influencing you. You see on Shabbat that he comes out and he's disrespectful to the Shabbat, you learn from him. You see him talking Lashon Hara every time he's out of the house, screaming, doing, saying wrong things, you learn from him. All those things are very, very much an influence on us and definitely on our children that don't have yet the strength to stand up for themselves. And but also a second perush, as we explained before, that od shelo tilkei mo bemapalato. If you have somebody who's wicked as a neighbor, you need to know that if he gets punished, when he will get punished, it's definitely punishment for every sin. But when he'll get punished, you need to know that it's very likely that the neighbor gets punished together with him. Why? Because the Torah says, Oy la rasha ve'oy lishcheno. This is how Chazal teach us, that once you are close to somebody who's bad, you are influenced, and secondly, even if not, but being close to him makes you vulnerable to any punishment that he will get. So therefore, stay away. Chazal say, if a thorn is being uprooted from the ground, that's a problem also for the cabbage. Why? Because many times the people that try to pick up the thorns would by mistake also pick out some cabbages, some good things. So therefore, even if you're good, and even if you make sure to do, as we explained before, that every time he comes around, you make sure that you stay home, you don't take your kids to see how he's doing what he's doing, but still, you're bringing yourself close to such a person, so the thorn is also hurting the cabbage, the good cabbage. That's what Shlomo HaMelech tells us in Mishlei, Al telech baderech itam, menar aglecha menitivatam. Don't go in their ways. Make sure to stay away from them. Who was the one that gets the beautiful credit for such a thing, that doing the right thing? Noach. Ele toldot Noach. Noach ish tzadik, tamim haya bedorotav. Noach is worthy of the praise, ish tzadik tamim. Why is Noach worthy of such a title? Because, as the Sifte Chachamim, he stay away from the people. And the Torah says, lelamedcha shikar toldotem shel tzadikim asim tovim. These are all considered good deeds. These are all considered mitzvot. At the time that he stays home, he gets rewarded for that. I wasn't able to reach out to the people like Avraham Avinu. He did his own ability up to what he knew he was able to do. And therefore, because of that, HaKadosh Baruch Hu tells him, you know what? I'm going to help you out, get some real praises. Go out there and build the Teva 120 years. 120 years, people will come out and you'll be able to tell them, I'm building a Teva because the rain is coming down. On the same time you're building the Teva, you are protected, you are segba mitzvah, you're not being easy with reaching out to the people where you can't, but on the same time, you are reaching out to the people. And again, we're saying that this is the Musar to us today. Each one of us should pick up that opportunity. If you know that you're able to go to speak to the people, like Avraham Avinu, that you could go out yourself, that you are, like it says, Hitalech lefanai ve'etamim, asher italachti lefanav, Avraham Avinu, that you are independent, which means you know you can be influenced, as the Sifte Chachamim said, fine, ashrecha. But if you think you are such a way, such a level, as many of us not, so today we said there's an opportunity, a beautiful opportunity to help out in so, so many different ways from your own home without going out and reaching out physically to the people. You can reach out to people, not physically, and change their lives and make people what they should be. And on that, you get the reward that Hashem says over here, Ish Tzadik Tamim. Shabbat Shalom.